In the previous tutorial, we accessed a web API through a predetermined URL. That may not be useful in many cases, and most of the times we might prefer to get the URL from HMI or PLC registers instead. The idea is straightforward, but you may encounter a nuisance in practice. In our JavaScript environment, getting data from HMI registers is achieved with the getData method. However, as data is in the form of binary data, it needs to be converted to string before it can be used for URL. In this tutorial, we will try to form a complete URL by combining a fixed partial URL with a string from HMI registers. There are three sections to this video. 1. EB Pro setting. 2. JavaScript source code explained. 3. Demo and debugging. Here we are using the same website from the last tutorial for demonstration. Now we're going to use the JS function in EasyBuilder Pro to get the data from the website. We want to get the data from this URL, swapi.dev/api/people/1. But this time we will only set partial URL in JavaScript. The last number will be read from HMI's register, so we can get different person's data while HMI is running. We need to import the web request source code in JS resource first, just like the previous tutorial. Create a combo button and select execute JS in action group 1. In the config list, press new value and set the type as string. Enter the partial URL, swapi.dev/api/people/. Click new value again, set LW0 as where to put the web data. Create another address LW50 named number. This is where we change the last number of the final URL. This is the JavaScript source code. Paste the code in the source code field. The code from line 1 to 9 is the same as the previous tutorial. Line 11 to 15 is a function to convert the data from binary to string data type. Line 17 to 28, we use the try statement in case the code doesn't run, it will end the code and print error message. Line 18 to 19 will get the number from LW50, and convert the data type from binary to string. Line 20 will combine the partial URL and the input number into a complete URL. Line 21 to 23 will call the get function in JS resource code, and send the request to the web server. Press OK to finish the JS setting. Create an ASCII object with LW0 to see the data obtained by using JS action. Create an ASCII object with LW50 to input the number of URL. Run offline or online simulation. Enter different numbers in LW50 and press the combo button to see the results. Now right-click on CMT Viewer and select Diagnoser. Enter the letter A in LW50 and press Combo button. The Diagnoser will print the error message which says the data must be a string. We can see that the error is coming from JS code line 8. Since the URL is invalid, the JS code does not receive meaningful data to write to LW0. You can use Diagnoser to check your code if it doesn't work. In this tutorial, we have shown how to send a web request where part of the URL comes from HMI or PLC registers. You can download the sample project in this video's information. Thank you for watching.